Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, a station whereby we are going to learn and interact together. We are going to have our biology form 4, lesson 11, whereby your tutor will be me, Mr. Gerald. We are going to handle the topic on genetics and the subtopic, comparative anatomy. Remember, actually this is an evidence of organic evolution. We are dealing with the evidences of organic evolutions. And in our lesson today, we are going to handle the comparative anatomy. So if you maybe you have not looked at our previous lessons on other evidences, make a point of having those lessons so that you might connect what you are doing. But before that, you are going to have the following lesson goals, whereby by the end of the lesson, you should be able to explain comparative anatomy. Let us now explain the comparative anatomy here. When comparing the form and the structure of different organisms, we notice that some groups show basic structural similarities. These similarities suggest that the organisms have a common or a related ancestry. Where the anatomical structures show many differences, such organisms have less evolutionary relationships. Where one basic structural form is modified to give rise to various different forms, the phenomenon is called divergent evolution. We are saying that divergent evolution is where organisms from the same basic structure, they have been modified to perform different functions. And then we can have a look at the divergent evolution. That one is an example of a divergent evolution because the beaks of these birds, actually the beaks are the same, but they have been modified to perform different functions. These divergent forms originating from a single ancestral form may each become adapted to a different ecological niche in the given habitat. For example, our first diagrammatic diagram here, the beak here is adapted to eat something like meat, that is the flesh, because after the Pangaea, the climate or the habitat that it went, there could not have been other means of survival other than feeding on meat. We have got our second diagrammatic representation here, which is the bird, and its beak is adapted to eat something like grains. We have got our fourth diagrammatic representation, because after Pangaea, this bird went to the waters, so it had to develop a mechanism of feeding. So that's why it has got a serrated beak. The evolutionary this actually evolutionary relationship of the adaptive this evolutionary phenomenon of divergent evolution is what we call the adaptive radiation. An example of adaptive radiation can be observed in homologous structures. So what we are seeing on our screen are what we are defining to as the homologous structures. Homologous structures are those that have a common embryonic origin but have been modified to perform different functions. Diversity of the vertebrate forelimb is one example of homologous structures. You can see the forelimbs here, actually they have the same origin. But as you can see, the human, the cat, the bat, the porpoises and the horse, the forelimbs, initially they looked the same. But due to Pangaea and other structures, all these they have been modified to perform different functions. The form and anatomy of the forelimb differ in various vertebrate groups, while their basic pentadactyl, that is the five structure, is retained. Actually, if you look at the forelimb of the human, it has got the five structures. We have got the cat, it has got the five structures. For the bat, we have got the five structures, and even for the horse. That is to mean they have got a common ancestor. The forelimb of a bat is modified to perform a wing for flight, while that of a horse is elongated to enhance speed in running. In the whale or the turtle, it is modified to perform a swimming flipper. Note that in these examples, the pentadactyl limb is modified to perform particular locomotory functions. These are flight, running, and swimming. Another example of adaptive radiation occurs in the beak of structure of birds. Let us look at the beak of structures of several birds. Beaks in birds have a common embryonic origins and basic structure. Depending on the type of food and mode of feeding. This basic structure is modified in length, shape, and also size. The short stout beaks are common in seed eaters, while the nectar feeders have long, slender beaks. Fruit eaters have relatively large beaks, and carnivorous birds have strong hooked beaks, as we can see from our first diagram. Similarly, the food structure in bird is that is the food structure. Let us look at the food structure also in birds. The food structure in birds is modified for various functions and habitats. Although their embryonic origin is origin is common, the webbed feet of ducks are used for wading, while the heavy clawed feet of eagles are used for grasping and tearing of prey. So let us, these are the different feet of birds showing the what we are calling adaptive radiation. So actually after the Pangaea, these birds, they had to, because they went to different environments with different climates, they had to adapt to all those climates. Having done and said that, we are going to have the following activity whereby you are required to discuss comparative anatomy as an evidence of organic evolution. For more of this biology lesson, you can refer to KLB Secondary Biology Student Book 4, which the 4th edition, Nairobi. It has been certified by the Kenya Literature Bureau. And to get this lesson and many more of our biology lessons, you can contact us by sending us an SMS through the number that is on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or our Facebook page, which is also Elimu TV, or you tweet us at Elimu_TV_Kenya. Let us subscribe to all these channels so that we will enjoy our biology lessons. Thank you.